Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we are going to study about the animal diversity 3. In that, chapter 4, that is introduction to subclass Pisces. In that, 4.2, that is class Contractis, example is Collodon and Chimera. And the class Ostractis, that is example is Labium Cutler. Here, as we know that, so class Placodermi is the class of extinct fishes. So the general characters of the class Placodermi. So before we are going to start the general characters of Placodermi, so as we know that class, that is the subphylum Vertebrata, is divided into two, that is division. First division is Agnatha and second is Gnathostomata. Again, Gnathostomata is divided into two classes, that is superclass Physis and superclass Tetrapoda. So superclass Tetrapoda, it includes all fishes. So in that, class Placodermi, class Contractis and class Ostractis. Only Contractis and Ostractis is included in your syllabus. So class Placodermi. Placodermi means the extinct fishes. What is mean by extinct? That is not present on earth. For example, dinosaurs. So we can study the dinosaurs with the help of their fossil. Okay. So general characters, they are extinct fishes. The body was fish-like and endoskeleton was bony. They had a bony armor on the head and the neck. That is head and the neck. It is protected by covering. That covering is a bony covering. Jaw were not properly formed and tail is a heterocercal type. Okay. So we are going to study in detail what is heterocercal type of tail. Tail. And jaw was not properly formed. Here the Clematis and Cocotis are the example. So this is the diagram of extinct fishes. Again, the next is class Chondroctis. The organisms or the fishes that comes under the class Chondroctis are marine freshwater on all predaceous. That is, for their nutrition or for their food, they completely depend on the other organisms. Endoskeleton. Endoskeleton is cartilaginous skeleton and scale, placoid type of scale that is present on the cartilaginous fishes. Again, the respiration. So the respiration with the help of gills, and 5 to 7 pairs of gill slits are present, and these gill slits not covered by the covering, that is operculum is the covering that covers the gill slits, but the gill slits are not, the gill covering was not there, that is no operculum. Here you can see the class Chondroctis, example is Chimera, sharks and the rays. These are the cartilaginous fishes, most primitive living vertebrates that have complete vertebra, movable jaws and the paired appendages. So class Chondroctis, it includes the characteristics, that is cartilaginous fishes, streamlined form with heterocercal tail, cartilaginous skeleton, leathery skin, placoid scale also known as dermal denticles, restricted notochord, mouth with two nostril ventral, jaw and paired appendages were present. Male with the claspers, again egg with the large yolk. And the next is respiration. As we know that respiration with the help of 5 to 7 pairs of the gill slits. So must swim to force water through their gill, such as nurse sharks can get enough oxygen, so they need not to swim. Here the fin is caudal type of fin is present in the cartilaginous fishes, and tail is a heterocercal type of scale. Heart is two chambered, that is one is aurical and one is ventricle. One is for is receiving the blood, another one for the pumping the blood. So brain is a large, and 10 pairs of cranial nerves were present or are present. Kidneys are a mesonephric type of kidneys are present. As we know that the pronephric, mesonephric and metanephric type of kidneys are present. 4 to 5 week of the embryonic development, that shows the mesonephric type of kidney, and then metanephric type of kidney present in the vertebrate. But in what we can say, in marine organism or in a fishes, the mesonephric type of kidneys are there. And excretion is ureotelic. As we know that there are three types of excretion, that is amniotelic, urotelic and uricotelic. Excretion is there. Now, when the excretory product is ammonia, that is ammoniotelic. Ureotelic, when the excretory product is urea. and urotilic means the uric acid is excretory product. You can see here the heart and the placoid scales. So sexes are separate. Fertilization is internal. When fertilization is inside the body, it is known as internal type of fertilization. Oviparous and oviviparous organisms. Development is direct and without metamorphosis. Direct development, as we know that, so larval form is not there, and metamorphosis, the developmental stages are not there. Examples, Scolodon, Prestris and Chimera. Here the reproduction in Contractis, that is oviparous, laying the eggs that hatch outside the mother's body. Example like hen that lays the egg, again incubate the leg, and after incubating the leg, the egg hatch, and from that egg chickens come out. So this is example is bird or the hen. Here ovoviviparous organism, brooding eggs that hatch within the mother's body and then releasing the young one. Snakes are the example, and some fishes, again viviparous type of organism. You can see the young develop within the uterus inside the mother's body, are nourished prior to the birth via connection with the mother's bloodstream, that is placenta. Here the reproduction, male and the female. So male and female sexes are separate, as we know that. You can see this is the female and this is the male of the shark. So ovary, the green color, that is the ovary, and this yellow one is the testes of this shark. Fertilization is internal, that is inside the body. Male transfer the sperm via claspers. The female have ovaries and the oviduct, that are the modified uterus. Most sharks that lays egg, then some pelagic shark that gives birth to the live young. Pelagic means upper layer of the water. They give directly birth to their young ones. Here the rat fishes, about 30 species of the rat fishes are grouped separately due to their unique characteristics, that is strange looking and mostly deep water, have only one pair of gill slits covered by a flap of skin, a long rat-like tail, feed on the bottom dwelling crustaceans and the mollusk, that is feeding on the crustaceans and the mollusk. Scolodon, this is the example of Scolodon. So